Hello, this is MIT OpenCourseWare Centric Wiki World University and Schools WUAS News and Question and Answer on Monday, May 13th, 2024 at 10 a.m. Eastern Time, 7 a.m. Pacific Time. I think it's around 7:30 p.m. India time, and potentially just before midnight, might be 11 p.m. Tokyo, Japan time, 3 p.m. Western European time. Please join these WUAS news and question and answers with your questions, with your answers, as we seek to grow 200 online, free to students, MIT OpenCourseWare centric. For WUAS degrees, World University and Schools, and Wiki Schools for people-to-people teaching and learning, for speakers of all 7,164 known living languages, and where there are about 750 pages, wiki pages in WUAS Mirahazen Media Wiki right now, where you can begin to teach Wiki Teach. As well as Wiki Learn and Wiki Create, presently we'll move into other languages with large language models, generative AI, in due course. And as we wait to see if people will join this WUAS news and question and answer, I would like to share a little news with you. The first item has to do further with this incredible WUAS revolutionizing education with artificial intelligence article from Peter Norvig and on the Tulify AI website. So I'd just like to read the table of contents to you. Revolutionizing education with machine learning and AI. Table of contents. It's about World University and School initially. And in that, Peter Norvig, head of Google Artificial Intelligence, and also the author or co-author of a leading artificial intelligence textbook, wrote, it adds tremendous credibility to World University and Schools' further developments and growth as we seek to accredit. So that's an agenda item, accreditation further on. Stay tuned. So here's the table of contents from this Tulify AI WUAS, that's a hashtag on Twitter. Revolutionizing education with machine learning and AI. Table of contents. One, introduction. Two, innovating with machine learning and artificial intelligence. 2.1, Peter Norvig's research at Google. 2.2, utilizing machine learning and AI in teaching. 2.3, expanding MIT OpenCourseWare through machine learning. Table of contents three, language diversity and machine learning. 3.1, the potential of machine learning in language translation. 3.2, developing courses in multiple languages. Four, Google's role in education innovation. 4.1, Google's artificial intelligence software, TensorFlow. 4.2, the future of MIT OpenCourseWare and World University in School, World University and School. Five, machine learning and artificial intelligence in virtual Earth. 5.1, creating a realistic virtual Earth. 5.2, collaboration between scientists and machine learning. Six, the study of bliss and enjoyment in learning. 6.1, flow, the psychology of optimal experience. a book by Csikszentmihalyi, published, I think, in 1991 first. 6.2, Exploring Bliss in a Virtual Harbin Hot Springs. 7, Conclusion. So that's the table of contents from this remarkable Tulified AI, WUAS, article written by artificial intelligence with Peter Norvig, and which opens remarkable new possibilities at World University and School. So that's agenda item 1 for today's WUAS news and question and answer. Agenda item 1A, the recording from the May 6th, 2024, last Monday's Open World University and School, WUAS Press, WUAS News and Question and Answer, on hashtag WUAS Revolutionizing Education AI article, and regarding Tulify AI, WUAS, and the flagship physical digital WUAS bookstore, potentially on Walnut Street in Shadyside in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Video recording is posted, and you can see it at the youtube.com/ScottMcLeod World University.com/videos YouTube channel, the current YouTube channel for World University and School, as well as in 2 blog posts in the worlduniversityandschool.blogspot.com blog post and in the scott-mcleod.blogspot.com blog post from Monday, May 6th, as well as it was about WUAS accreditation, that's also a hashtag, and A Realistic Virtual Earth, that's also a hashtag. Check it out. Agenda item C, or 3, for today, since agenda item B is the announcement for today's WUAS news and question and answer on 5/13/24. Agenda item C, WUAS accreditation further with MISH Middle States Commission on Higher Education may make it possible for ocw.mit.edu centric Wiki World University and School to begin to seek reimbursement from departments of education in all 200 countries and in all 50 US states along the lines of MIT tuition. And there's a web page for MIT's tuition outlining many different costs from rich countries. So a related Twitter post. Thanks to Middle States Commission on Higher Education for announcing this upcoming accreditation virtual webinar. Looking forward to 5/14, that's tomorrow, as World University and School grows major online hashtag WUAS, UNIVS, in all 200 countries and in languages. And there's the Tulify.ai article that I just shared the table of contents with you about with Connie Clifton and Edna Corbett, also both hashtags and also both, I think they're directors at, in one form or another, at Middle States Commission on Higher Education. And the set of Twitter posts continues. And with accreditation, with WUAS accreditation, seek reimbursement from 50 US states and all 200 countries' departments of education. And regarding possibly $63,000 per year per student from rich countries, and per the MIT article. And this retweets a Middle States Commission on Higher Education, which serves not only Pennsylvania, where it has its offices in the greater Philadelphia area, but I think New York and New Jersey and Maryland and Delaware and perhaps the British Virgin Islands and perhaps the Washington, D.C. area. So their tweet, which I retweeted, reads, "Have you and your institution been thinking about AI? Join us for, quote, harnessing the power of AI in higher education on May 14th. So this is great that Middle States Commission on Higher Education is developing with artificial intelligence. We've had the green light from Middle States Commission on Higher Education for more than a year now, and are continuing to get communications, attend a webinar with them, learn more about potentially World University and Schools Accreditation next steps with Middle States Commission on Higher Education. And this harnessing the power of AI in higher education at Middle States Commission on Higher Education webinar may be the way forward for World University and School, as we not only seek to begin accreditation in the state of Pennsylvania, where we have already received authorization for licensure from the state of Pennsylvania's Department of Education, but also potentially grow in all 200 countries and eventually in their main languages. And as we seek also to code for all 7.9 billion people on the planet, speakers of all 7,164 known living languages on the Wiki Schools people-to-people teaching side, but also from some of those people, perhaps they will choose to matriculate for free online WUAS degrees, which are MIT OpenCourseWare centric, from their homes in their countries, and how this will work out with accreditation with Middle States Commission on Higher Education might emerge further with this webinar tomorrow from Middle States Commission on Higher Education titled Harnessing the Power of AI in Higher Education. Agenda item D, or four, returning to the incredible article from Toolify AI and Peter Norvig, could Peter Norvig further develop 200 WUAS universities with expanding MIT OCW through machine learning and language diversity? And the set of tweets continues with Roland Vogel, who's the director of the Stanford Law Codex Center, develop 250 plus online WUAS law schools. And with Dr. Joseph C. Wu, MD, and Dr. Jonathan Chen, MD, PhD, I think Dr. Wu may be a PhD as well. Could they help? They're both Stanford professors. Could they help develop 250 plus online WUAS medical schools? And in a virtual earth, in a realistic virtual earth, and please read again the Toolify AI WUAS, that's a hashtag two, article from Peter Norvig and Toolify AI and from World University and School, or about World University and School. And this set of tweets retweets another tweet that I created about Quaker meetings in Central Edinburgh Quaker meeting and their picture of a Lego Quaker meeting, a Quaker meeting made out of Lego bricks and Lego people. So the tweet reads, a little hashtag Quaker meeting in Lego on hashtag Central Edinburgh Quaker meeting, hashtag Edinburgh Scotland's homepage. That homepage is quakerscotland.org/sites/quakerscotland.org. And further, the website is quakerscotland.org/central-edinburgh. I became a member of the Religious Society of Friends in Edinburgh, Scotland in 2004 on program Quakers. And as at World University and School seeks to make hashtag WUAS Lego Robotics central to hashtag free to students, hashtag MIT OCW centric, hashtag WUAS degrees in 200 countries and languages. So these hashtags are interesting, connecting social media, perhaps AI tools, conceivably. So check them out on Twitter. They can lead you to other tweets with other related ideas and communications, information technologically, that are helping to further create World University and School for hashtag free to students, hashtag MIT OCW centric, hashtag WUAS degrees in 200 countries and languages. Agenda item E or five. This further builds on the Tulify AI WUAS article, how 200 OCW.MIT.edu WUAS universities will grow with AI and machine learning. See this article. Thanks, Peter Norvig, for the Tulify AI WUAS article. And regarding especially MIT OCW through machine, expanding MIT OCW through machine learning, and regarding especially language diversity, and further especially regarding creating a realistic virtual earth. And lastly, further and especially exploring bliss in a virtual Harbin hot springs. Agenda item F, this has to do with a realistic virtual earth for archaeology, where you could time slide back to Çatalhöyük, which is a UNESCO World Heritage Site in central Turkey, and where archaeologists could begin to further create a virtual Çatalhöyük in central Turkey that would develop for archaeology. So in Google Street View with TimeSlider, Colleen Morgan, who's a UC Berkeley PhD in archaeology, but now at the University of York in England, I think, and virtual Çatalhöyük. She started building a virtual Çatalhöyük in the mid 2000, in, around 2008, perhaps somewhat before that, in the 3D virtual world of Second Life, where I've taught a course for many years on Harvard's virtual island called Society and Information Technology. So the set of tweets reads in Google Street View with TimeSlider, CL Morgan, virtual Çatalhöyük, colleen-morgan.com blog post from 2008 grows regarding Second Life, the 3D group buildable virtual world. And regarding my blog post, Scott-McLeod from 2019, Colchicum, Stanford, Complexity of Open, and Realistic Virtual Harbin, regarding my Harbin Hot Springs ethnographic book, and regarding hashtag physical digital, hashtag a realistic virtual earth for archaeology, hashtag with a realistic virtual earth for robotics, and hashtag WUAS humanoid robotics, hashtag THR3s. Toyota Humanoid Robot 3, which is the remarkable humanoid robot first emerging around 2017 publicly, I think, which is about 5.5 feet tall from Toyota, which I think is continuing to be in development. Could they become virtual archaeologists, digital, physical, sorry, physical archaeologists, these robots, these humanoid robots, THR3s, and in a way be operated to, besides being autonomous systems, also be operated out of a realistic virtual earth for robotics and working in a physical archaeological site and bringing data, for example, and artifacts into a realistic virtual earth for archaeology. It's possible. And this retweets a tweet that Stanford Law professor Hank Greeley had posted, a model of the Neolithic proto-city Çatalhöyük in modern-day Turkey in 7300 BC, around 5,000 people lived There, in a dense jumble of homes, most homes could only be accessed by walking across the rooftops. Crazy to me that something this legit was happening 93 centuries ago. Check out these Twitter posts in today's blog post from scott-mcleod.com, scott-mcleod.blogspot.com on Monday, 5/13/2024, and worlduniversityandschool.blogspot.com on May 13th, 2024. So agenda item G. So this is a new development in machine learning at the molecular level for molecular biology, and from Google Deep Brain. And the title of this Twitter post, I think, or a blog post from Google was AlphaFold 3 predicts the structure and interactions of all of life's molecules. And the set of tweets I created reads, wow, AlphaFold 3 takes us beyond proteins to a broad spectrum of biomolecules. This leap could unlock more transformative science, end quote. And I continue to accelerate hashtag WUAS drug design and hashtag WUAS genomics research. Steps to hashtag realistic virtual earth 4, hashtag 4 proteins, hashtag 4 pharmaceuticals, hashtag aging reversal machine. And this retweets Sundar Pichai, the CEO of Google and Alphabet's Twitter post, which reads, 1.8 million plus researchers have used at Google DeepMind's AlphaFold protein predictions in their work on vaccine development, cancer treatment, plus more. AlphaFold 3 is the latest breakthrough, predicting the structures and interactions of all of life's molecules with unprecedented accuracy. We're sharing access to these capabilities through AlphaFold Server to enable other scientific discoveries. And he included a blog post from Google, blog.google, which is titled, scrolling up to the top of it, AlphaFold 3 predicts the structure and interactions of all life's molecules. Introducing AlphaFold 3, a new AI model developed by Google DeepMind and Isomorphic Labs, by accurately predicting the structure of proteins, DNA, RNA, ligands, and more, and how they interact. We hope it will transform our understanding of the biological world and drug discovery. Is this revolutionary? Potentially. So, agenda item G2. And in what ways, at Hank Greeley, LSJU, Leland Stanford Junior University, and at John Cumbers, all could hashtag AlphaFold 3 be emerging hashtag CS vocabulary, computer science vocabulary, to also predict hashtag gene expression, and with the blog web URL for this article, and in building a realistic virtual earth for genetics, that's a hashtag too. For example, in hashtag G Street View with hashtag Time Slider, hashtag G Cell View, hashtag G Atom View. So that's a set of tweets that I wrote and retweeted. Another indication of this is from Philip C. Ball, a journalist in Great Britain, that Professor Hank Greeley retweets a lot. Philip Ball's tweet reads, another indication of the complexity of gene expression. In this case in regard to splicing. My sense in this very interesting paper is that we will still lack the vocabulary to talk about the organizational and spatio-temporal processes here. Hashtag how life works. So my tweet that retweeted this brings into possibility using Google Street View with TimeSlider, Google Cell View, Google Atom View for spatio-temporal processes. The article that Philip Ball refers to is a Nature.com article. So check these out. These are fascinating reads in remarkable developments in machine learning with many, many implications for understanding how life works. Agenda item G3, another set of tweets that I created. And if hashtag extreme longevity genetic drugs, and check out the worlduniversityandschool.blogspot.com longevity blog label, if extreme longevity genetic drugs emerge with and hashtag aging reversal machine, what kind of hashtag WUAS society do we educate for, e.g. in America with democracy? In, for example, the year 2458, so about 434 years from now, and there's the link to the Google blog post regarding AlphaFold 3. And what kinds of consciousness do we want to educate for? Two, and a link to my blog label, scott-mcleod.blogspot.com/search/label/consciousness. So when in the American school system, and in American society, we educate people for a whole variety of reasons. Public education is very widespread. Possibly 95-98% of students in the US have access to free public education through the high school level and through some college. And we don't often think about kinds of consciousness that we educate for. But I, as a social scientist and a writer about questions of consciousness, having written my first actual virtual Harbin Hot Springs ethnographic book. Harbin Hot Springs is also known as Heart Consciousness Church. I'm interested in questions of understanding consciousness philosophically. An intractable philosophical question at this point, but think that thinking a little bit about how we educate for possibility of extreme longevity genetic drugs moving forward in, for example, America with our American democracy, 400 years from now, 80,000 years from now, if each of you and I are still alive as organisms, as individual people, thinking about the kind of consciousness we might educate for has some merit, as I think about it. And in the World University and School, building on MIT OpenCourseWare courses for free MIT OpenCourseWare-centric WUAS university degrees, we'll also perhaps be considering some of these questions as we hire faculty and grow with artificial intelligence and machine learning and language diversity. So agenda item H, let me just check if anyone is seeking to join us. I'm checking on my smartphone. Nope. No one seeking to join us by sending, for example, an email. to me, saying they want to join, having sent out an email to about 500 people announcing this 12 hours before this began. Agenda item H, a new hashtag Mexico WUAS, hashtag WUAS University. First courses in Spanish. This is a CS First with Google course in Spanish. CS First with Google at WUAS course. Quote, and my, please excuse my Spanish. I don't know Spanish. Quote, CS First, un plan de estudios que facilita la enseñanza de la programación y la hache divertida de aprender. And the website for this free course, that is where you, self-directed, you can do this on your own in Spanish, csfirst.withgoogle.com/s/es/home. And hashtag MIT OCW Spanish courses. And there's a link to MIT Open Courseware Spanish courses that have been translated, I think, from MIT Open Courseware in English. And the very beginning, Mexico World University and School University Wiki page, wiki.worlduniversityandschool.org/wiki/Mexico, capital M. Hashtag WUAS Mexico, Mexico. So check out this set of tweets as well and start teaching and learning, either on the wiki side or you can, if you're a Spanish speaker and want to study for free WUS MIT OCW centric degrees at World University and School in Spanish, you can matriculate in to World University and School with this CS First with Google at WUS course that I just, title of which I just read in Spanish. So agenda item I, next World University and School WUS news and question and answer is next week, May 20th, 2024 at 10 a.m. Eastern Time, 7 a.m. Pacific Time. Come join us with your questions. All the best. Abolitionally friendly regards, Scott G.K. McLeod. And a P.S. with our MIT Open Courseware Centric World, Wiki World University and School, WUAS Educational Services stores for books, computers, robotics, business plan for a startup business 2024 with a link to a Google Docs with this business plan. Check it out as well. All right, that's the news for today. I'm going to post the recording of this to youtube.com/ScottMcLeod World University, as well as to our main Twitters, twitter.com/WORLDUNIVANDSCH and twitter.com/WUASPRESS. If you have questions, if you'd like to matriculate at World University and School, if you'd like to join the next World University and School WS News and Question and Answer on Monday, May 20th, 2024, please email sgkmacleod@worlduniversityandschool.org. Worlduniversityandschool.org is also currently our beginning homepage. Thanks so much to the Tulify AI WUAS incredible article from Peter Norvig, revolutionizing education with artificial intelligence, World University and School. Till next time, see you.